Watch this video to the end so I know how to cut this thing. I'm cutting a padded and I'm using pattern on it. Yes, I'm using this pattern. And after that, I'm using to cut the main fabric. And this is the pattern. I'm going to be folding it like this. Take, remove 5-6 inches. Depends how low you want it to be because I'm making it off shoulder. So I remove 6 inches and the upper bust. Please, upper bust is very important when you're making padded, whichever padded you're making, whichever blouse I'm making, upper bust is very, very important. That after upper bust is after in between your shoulder to your bust. So my upper bust here is 7 and my arm hold here is 8. Shoulder divided by 2 is 8, 16 is 8. And my breast point is 12, under bust is 16, and my waistline. I'm making a peplum blouse. I'm adding peplum on the down part. Now you take the nipple to nipple. My nipple to nipple is 8. Please watch my video. I made a video on how to know your nipple to nipple and your breast point. Please try and watch my video so that to make this so when we're making your breast, your padded, it will be very easy for you. Instead of trying to calculate and know how to get it, just watch the video. You will know how to get your nipple to nipple and your breast point. My nipple to nipple here is 4 plus 2 allowance, 1/2 inches. That is 4.5. I'm going to be taking this 4.5 all the way down. Make straight line for it. After that, you make straight line 4.5 and make straight line. Now I'm coming to the. I want to take the. We're taking the ones I want. Now, if your bust is 45, on this side part, you remove 2 inches. From 45 up, remove 2 inches. But from 40 down, remove 1.5. 1.5 like this. You can remove 1 inches if you like. But that 1.5 is okay. Or 1.25. You can remove 1.25 whichever way. Now let's take for the sake of this tutorial, I'm taking 1.5 and come to the upper side. Please, when you're taking this upper side, not this upper side here, no, it's from this the upper side I said before that I remove from my own 7. Your own maybe 6, whichever way. And from that 7, from this upper bust here, remove 1.5. Whatever you remove from this under bust, that is the same one you remove from this bust point. And now you're going to take it and make it straight to the upper side. And come to this side. From this 1.5, you take it down to the waist line and make straight line on it to this side. Please, when you are making this dress, you must use your French cuff on it. When you are making this dress, this is the French cuff. This one is for the padded. This is the padded. This one is for padded. This one here is for the neck part and the arm hold. Don't cover your padded without this thing, please. Unless you know you can cover it. But especially from the beginners, you just make use of this French cuff. Look for it and get it. And come to this side of this upper side, this middle part here, and come to this middle part here. Please remove 1/2 inches. Don't remove more than 1/2 inches. Sometimes I don't remove, but if you like, you can remove 1/2 inches on this particular 1/2 inches. And this this middle part here, please and please don't remove anything from this middle part. The reason why I said is that after joining the padded, it will balance well. But even if you remove quarter on it, when you join it and wear it, will not balance. That is why I don't advise my students to do that. Don't remove anything from this middle part, this under bust part. Just come to this upper bust, remove 1/2 inches. Just half, don't remove one, just 1/2 inch. Okay, but sometimes I don't remove. Also, I remove 1/2 inches. But on this waist side, don't remove any one there. And go and come to this breast point. This is my breast point here. My breast point is 12. And from this breast point, please come down by 1 inches here. I repeat, from this breast point, come down by 1 inches and go up again by 1 inches. Now I'm going to be curving this from this 1 inch that I come down, curve it down to me to this 1.5 inches. Also the same thing na that cassava. You be putting it like this. Make sure that your this French curve here, it touches this one and a half here. It touches it and touches the one that I come down with. Make sure that when you are curving it, it's nothing like sharp edge or anything. And when you are curving it, it will still jam with this breast point there. And take it to this upper side. Look at the upper side like this. Look at the upper side. And shape it like that. Remember, I said make sure it joint it touches this around this. So this is the thumb part. This is the upper side. And this particular side here, take the hammer to your friend curve again. Make sure it jam, it touch with this 1 inch you go up with, and make sure that there's nothing like a sharp edge there. Everything is curved. This is how to cut perfect padded. Yes. So when you follow this method, when you, after joining your padded, you will see that it will come out in a good form. There will not be any sharp edge on this middle part, and everything will balance. It will look like the one I showed you. It will look like this particular one. This thing, I don't wear bra with it. You don't wear bra because you know what to cut. So this is how to cut this particular. I'm going to be cutting it now. Remember, I hope you understood what I said. Please watch my video on how to know your breast point, nipple to nipple. It will be of help for you. I'm going to be cutting it out. Now I'm going to be cut from this side. Start from this. This particular one and a half I took from this other, but take it down to this waistline. Even if you are making a full blouse, evil blouse, just take it like this. When you get to this under the bust, you make a curve. Follow the line. Make sure you follow the line. Follow the line very well. After you finish making this target, fast, you will love using this method. Remember, I from this upper bust, I removed the 1.5. Not this up yet. From this upper bust here, 7 and 2. This is what you need. And take this, and take that same 1.5. Straight it down and cut it. Look at what I did here. Cut it like this. And cut this side again. This is the part. Remember, I said it again. Don't remove anything on that waist side from the middle part. So I'm done with this cutting. And please, this is what I advise you. This particular line I do here, you're going to be notching every one of it here. You will see the reason why I say you should notch it. You notch this particular side here. Now you notch everyone. The reason why I notch it, you see, you're going to notch the breast point, both the ham hole, the upper bust side. Just notch all the line in it so that when you are joining it, after joining them together, when you are joining it, you will know where the place will be. So it won't be confusing or difficult to know where the breast point is, where the waistline is, where the upper bust is. So that is why it's important for you to notch it, for you to know where the part of the dress, the part of the line is. So this is how to cut perfect padded blouse. Thanks for watching. Thank you.